Hey there, Benjamin from Loves Data here. Welcome to my Insiders Update. Today I'm covering GA4, Google Analytics 4 announcements Google has made about two of the most requested metrics people have wanted to see in the new version of Google Analytics. There are also new dimensions, and I want to briefly outline some of my latest tutorials. Google has announced they're adding conversion rate to GA4. This is probably the number one requested metric people have wanted to see added to the latest version of Google Analytics. So it's great to see this is finally being added. Google is adding two conversion rate metrics. You'll be able to use session conversion rate, which is the percentage of sessions that triggered any conversion event. And you'll also be able to use user conversion rate, which is the percentage of users that triggered any conversion event. It's great to see these metrics being added to GA4. It's also worth mentioning that conversions work slightly differently to goals in Universal Analytics. A goal in Universal Analytics can be counted once per session, while a conversion in GA4 can be counted multiple times in a session. If you'd like to learn how to configure a conversion in GA4, then I've included a link to my dedicated tutorial in the description below this video. Now, you're probably wondering where you can find these conversion rate metrics in GA4. Google has said that the metrics will be available in the standard reports, exploration reports, audiences, segments, and the data API. These metrics, along with other metrics and dimensions we're about to talk about, are still rolling out to accounts, so I recommend keeping an eye out to see when they're added to your GA4 properties. I haven't seen them in my properties yet, but I'm sure they'll be added soon. I will be covering them in future videos, so if you haven't already, take a moment to subscribe to my channel for the latest updates. Google has also announced they're adding bounce rate to GA4. It's different from the bounce rate you'll find in Universal Analytics. It's really the non-engagement rate for sessions, but I'll talk more about that in a moment. The really important thing about this addition is that Google is listening to people's feedback. After originally pushing engagement rate as a replacement for bounce rate, it's great to see Google reconsidering some decisions they've made about Google Analytics. Okay, let's take a closer look at bounce rate. In Universal Analytics, bounce rate was the percentage of sessions that included a single page view. So if someone viewed a single page and then left, no matter how long they spent on the page, it was considered a bounce. Bounce rate is different in GA4. It's the percentage of sessions that weren't engaged. This means if someone views a single page on your website and leaves within 10 seconds, then it will be considered a bounce and used to calculate the bounce rate. And if you're wondering, an engaged session is any session that lasts longer than 10 seconds, includes at least one conversion event, or has at least two page views. So just remember, bounce rate in GA4 is the percentage of sessions that are not engaged sessions. And apart from bounce rate and conversion rate metrics being added to GA4, Google is also adding new dimensions for your campaign tagged URLs. You'll be able to use dimensions for content and term tags you've added to your URLs. If you're running any inbound marketing, you should add campaign tags to your URLs. We've been able to use dimensions for campaign name, source, medium, and campaign ID in GA4 for a while. But now we'll also be able to use the term and content dimensions too. You'll be able to use the first user manual ad content and the session manual ad content dimensions to report on your content tags. And you'll also be able to use the first user manual term and the session manual term dimensions for your term tags. Again, the metrics and dimensions we've discussed are still rolling out, so keep an eye out for when they're added to your GA4 properties. I also want to mention some of my recent tutorials on YouTube. Please take a moment to check them out. I've included links in the description below this video. You'll find videos covering video tracking, Google Search Console, Google Tag Manager, installing GA4 on WooCommerce, and more. That's all for now, and as always, if you found this video helpful, please like it so I know to make more videos like this one. I'll see you in the next video.